this video, we'll cover how to download a Verifone VX series device. Before we begin, you'll need to make sure you have your terminal ID, your download URL or IP address, your SSL setting, and an application name if it's a single app download. When you start, your terminal may be on one of several different screens. Mine is currently on a payment application, but you may be starting from a screen that says download needed, or from a completely different screen. We can start the process the same way on all screens. So press F2 and F4 at the same time. It will prompt for the password. The default password on this device is 1-alpha-alpha-6-6-8-3-1, and enter. And the first menu screen it loads, option 2 will be to download, so we'll press the 2, and it's going to jump into asking group ID 1. This will always be the same unless otherwise specified by your processor, so we'll just press enter here. It will prompt you for the group ID 1 password, which generally is the same default password, which is 1-alpha-alpha-6-6-8-3-1, and enter. The terminal will now prompt single app or multi-app, so unless your processor told you to download a single app, we will always use 2 for multi-app. Next prompt is full download or partial download, and again, unless otherwise stated, we will always use 1, full download. And then it'll say GIDs to erase 1, change choices, or continue. Well, we want to delete the group 1 so it has space for the new download, so we'll press 2 to continue. It'll flash deleting files and take us to the communication menu. We're going to do this download over the internet, so we need to choose the TCP/IP option. We will scroll down to the next page by pressing the far left purple key and then selecting 3 for TCP/IP. That's going to load the comm server application. Once in the comm server application, the terminal will prompt us if we want download or FTP. Download is already selected, so we will press enter. It will move to the comm technology section. Default interface is already selected. The default interface for this device is Ethernet, so you can choose either of the first two options. I'll leave it at default interface and press enter. It'll now take us to a screen that has 3 new options. We want to continue with the download, so I'll just leave that highlighted and press enter. And then the terminal is going to begin asking us for the parameters about your download. The first parameter here is the URL or address. If this is already correct in your device, you can go ahead and press enter to bypass it. However, if you need to change it, you can select edit. The terminal will prompt if it's going to be a URL string or if it's just going to be an IP address. In my case, it's a URL string, so I will press enter, and it's going to prompt me for that URL string. Now, my address is already correct in here, but I'm going to knock out the last 3 digits, 4 digits here, and I'll show you how to enter those in so as you're typing in your own, you understand how to do it. First, notice that the letters, or each key has letters on it. The 1 also includes a period. So in order to do a dot, I'll select 1, and I'll press the alpha key 3 times to get a period. We need to add COM to the end of this. So for the C, I'm going to press 2 and 3 alphas, and I'm going to press 6 and 3 alphas for the O, and 6 alpha for M. Once your address is entered correctly, go ahead and press enter. It's now going to ask you for the port number. Again, the far right purple button will allow you to edit that field if it's not correct. You can erase out whatever is in there and put in the proper port number. Mine is correct, so I will press enter. It's then going to ask you if SSL is true or false. If it is set correctly, again, enter will bypass, but you can always select edit. This time you're going to use the 2 far left purple keys to scroll up and down through the true and false options, select the correct one, and press enter. Block size at 1000 is default. This should stay the same unless otherwise told to change it, so we'll always just leave that at 1000. Heap size is empty. This is another defaulted field, so unless you're otherwise told to change it, just press enter. The terminal ID is the file that contains all of your merchant information. So this is what the terminal is going to download. So this is very important to have this correct. Again, you'll select edit. If it's not correct already, clear out whatever's in there, type this in. Occasionally terminal IDs do have letters, so you'd use the same, press the number, hit the alpha key to scroll through the digits or the characters on that key to set that. And then once you have that correct, you just press enter. Application name, star MA. If you selected multi-app load at the beginning of this file, at the beginning of this install, this should already be set to star MA. If it is not, and you are doing a multi-app download, just go ahead and edit and change that to star MA. If you're doing a single app download, you'll most likely need to edit this, clear it out, and type in whatever the application name is that your processor provided. Go ahead and press enter here. This is prompting if the download is resumable. False is the standard, so we will just leave it at false and press enter. And we'll start with the first of four summary screens. These summary screens can be bypassed by pressing enter, and they just go through the same information you've just updated or reviewed. The last summary screen just reviews that the resumable download is set to false. Pressing enter on this screen will begin the download. When the download starts, you will see a series of dashes on the screen. As these dashes turn to stars, the download is progressing, so it's basically a progress bar. Each star represents 10% of the download done. Now let's see if we can get a star to pop. And there we go. So, these dashes will convert to stars throughout the rest of the download. When the download is finished, the terminal should reboot and automatically start installing the application that it has downloaded. If for some reason it doesn't, you come back to the machine and it says download done and it's just sitting there, you can just press the green enter key. That will have the terminal reboot and start the extraction process. Once the download is complete and the terminal is installed with the software, the terminal should take you back either to the payment application itself, or it may take you back to an application menu where you may have options like comm server, credit debit, soft pay. Generally, there'll only be two options unless you're installing like gift and loyalty as a separate application, or check service as a separate application. So comm server will be the system that connects it to the internet and handles that communication. The other option, whether it's soft pay or credit debit or some other name, is most likely going to be your payment app. So you can select that option. It should load your payment screen, and from there you should be able to run a test transaction.